नमस्ते बच्चों, हमेशा खुश रहो। माय सेल्फ जेविन डॉक्टर मोनिका त्रिवेदी। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू अबाउट ट्रांजिशन मेटल डाइनाइट्रोजन एंड डाइऑक्सीजन कॉम्प्लेक्सेस। ओके, दिस टॉपिक बिलोंग्स टू एन ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री सेकेंड एमएससी केमिस्ट्री सेकेंड सेमेस्टर। सो इन प्रीवियस सेशंस वी हैव लर्न अबाउट metal carbonyl compound. Now we have to learn about dinitrogen complexes. Okay, so the metal dinitrogen complexes are a coordination compound that contain the dinitrogen, which is N2, as a ligand. N2 reacts with the metal like lithium and magnesium to give a nitride, but the only other than known biological reaction of the N2 under the mild condition is formed of N2 complexes. Okay, the discovery of the coordination compound containing the nitrogen molecule as a ligand is one of the most excited recent development in the chemistry of the nitrogen. In 1930, it was shown that the molybdenum was essential for the growth of the nitrogen fixation bacteria. In the absence of any source in a nitrogen other than dinitrogen, but in the presence of the urea or ammonia, the bacteria appear to grow happily in the absence of the molybdenum. Thus, the molybdenum appears to be directly involved with the nitrogen molecule in the process of the fixation. This norms lead to attempt to produce dinitrogen complexes by comparing the gas over the molybdenum compound, but with no success. The dinitrogen complex are known for early or middle transition element with the N2 displaying either terminal or a bridge or the side on condition mode. Some of these complexes active the rather inert N2 for the further functionalization. However, the hydrogenation reaction is a facial only in the few interest and cannot appear to be biological nitrogen fixation. Still, the N2 complexes of the transition metal serves as a suitable model for active site for nitrogenations and provide the suitable platform for further improvement to enable conversion of the N2 into the hydrides, as well as the functionalization for the convention and other useful molecules. So this is the MO diagram of ligand N2. You can see here the 2s orbital, which is totally fulfilled, and you can see the 2p orbitals of N and N, which is two nitrogen atom. You can see the p orbital is filled by 3 electrons, and if you can see the bonding orbitals are completely filled and antibonding are completely unfilled. So if you can calculate the bond order of N2, it will become 3. Okay, so here you can see 3 type of bonding modes are observed in a dinitrogen complexes, which are terminal. You can see in a first image where metal is attached with a nitrogen 1, and which is attached with another nitrogen with the triple bond. Okay, the second bond is bridging bond, where you can see the 2 metal are appear and 2 nitrogens combined with a triple bond, and metal are present. Okay, second bridging type. Second, what happened when the nitrogen combined with 1 bond and the nitrogen and metal combined with 2 bonds. Okay, pi bond is present in metal and nitrogen. And if the side on bond, with what happened when side on bond, the nitrogen and nitrogen combined with bonded with a triple bond, and the metal combined with these triple bond. Okay, so this type of bond is known as a side on bond. Okay, then first we hear about terminal mode bond. Okay, the terminal modes, in a most cases the N2 is a terminal bonded by the 1N atom, as in a you can see in a one first image terminal bond. N2 is isoelectrical, so with the CO, so as compared between these two ligand, CO has a field sigma lone pair orbital located on the carbon with which it forms a sigma bond to the metal, and the empty pi orbital for the back bonding. in case of CO. N2 has also the field sigma lone pair, but it lays at a lower energy than the corresponding to the orbital CO, probably because nitrogen is more electronegative than carbon, and so N2 is a weaker sigma donor. N2 also has a empty pi orbital. Although it is a lower in energy and so more accessible than the CO pi orbital, it is equally distributed over N1 and N2, and therefore the metal nitrogen pi star overlap is similar than the metal CO, where the pi star is prominently located on a carbon. The nitrogen molecule associated with the metal center of the either electron rich low vacant metal or electron deficient metal in a high oxidation state. The pi back bonding from electron rich metal center is a reason for the stability of the molecule nitrogen associated with the sigma bond from the lone pair on a dinitrogen is the stabilizing or electron deficient metal center. Okay, the first dinitrogen complexes to be recognized is ruthenium NH3 Hall 5 N2 bracket 2 plus. It was isolated in 1965, and this is the structure of ruthenium NH3 Hall 5 N2. You can see here the nitrogen N2 ligand is bonded with ruthenium metal by the terminal side of complex. Okay. The second is a bridging mode. What happened in a bridging mode? The two end of nitrogen are the similar. The molecule can easily act as a bridging ligand between the two metals. If the back donation is large than the N2. Okay. If the back donation is large, the N2 can be reduced to a hybridized complex. So the example of the complexes in which the N2 bridge to two metals, in the ruthenium case, the system resemble, you can see in this equation, the ruthenium NH3 Hall 5 N2, which is a terminal mode complex. If we have two moles of this complex, we can get the bridge mode of this compound. Okay, so we get here the twice mole of ruthenium NH3 whole twice, and mu is for the bridging compound. Okay, so the next is side on mode. The side on bonding mode is rare. Okay, the first side on N2 complex was synthesized by the Ozine in 1973. The first side on N2 complex crystal structure was determined in 1882. In this complex, N2 bind in N1, it is a, you can say it in eta 1 and mu 2 and eta 2 function 2 ti2 unit. Side on overlap gives other ligand access to both N2 pi star modes MOs. So here you can see the complexes which are example of side on mode bonding in dinitrogen ligands. Okay, the second topic of today's session is dioxygen complexes. The dioxygen metal complexes are an extremely important class of the metal complexes that are involved in biological, physical, and industrial processes. Dinitrogen metal complexes are studied in two aspects, where the neutral oxygen carrying the system are studied to understand the mechanism of oxygen carrying and the storage. Okay, on the other hand, the synthesis dinitrogen complexes find application as artificial oxygen carriers and in the hemoglobin's catalyst. According to the molecule orbital theory, dinitrogen is a paramagnetic species which can bind with the almost all the transition metal ion in various bonding mode in act of this strong oxygen in a singlet form. In the metal complexes, dinitrogen binds as a superoxo and peroxo species. The dinitrogen metal complexes are mainly synthesized by the reaction of metal ion with the gases of O2, and the other method of synthesized dinitrogen complexes involve the use of the superoxide and peroxide anions. Okay, in a molecular metal complexes, dinitrogen bind with the two different form of sub end on and side on. Okay, here you can see the metal attached with the dinitrogen, which is end on, and the side on metal oxygen combined with the two oxygen molecules combined with the metal. Okay, so it is a superoxide and peroxide. Okay, the end-on bridge mode is generally found in the myoglobin and the hemoglobin, and the binding is believed to take place by the transfer of electron from metal to H2, generated the superoxide anion, which is O2 negative. The side-on mode is a most common bridging mode in a dioxygen coordination complexes. This mode is often seen in when the O2 binds to the Waskas complex and many other metal complexes. Okay, here you can see another example of the dioxygen molecule. The binuclear metal complexes superoxide or peroxide dioxygen display a binuclear binding mode in a metal complexes containing two metal ions, where the nitrogen molecules is bonded to two metal ions. Here you can see the oxygen binded with the metal, two metals, by bridging point, by metal and metal bond, or oxygen and oxygen bond. So here are the three type are present in a bridge bond. Okay, the biologically oxygen dioxygen metal complexes are present, like hemoglobin. Here you can see the structure of hemoglobin, oxymyoglobin, where O2 is present as a ligand. Another example is Waskas complex, which is a trichlorocarbonyl bis triphenyl phosphine iridium complex. Okay, here you can see when this yellow complex combined with the O2 and ligand, it converts into orange color. And hemocyanin, the dioxygen molecule binds with the two copper ion, in which mu2N2N2 per oxo O2 minus fission. Here you can see the structure of this hemocyanin complex. Okay, thank you very much. This session powered by Digital Version 2.0 Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. Hope you satisfy with my video. If you have any query, please let me know. Please comment me, and thank you very much.